The model 2241-3RK2 response kit comes in a rugged, waterproof carrying case. It features the model 2241-3 digital meter, a 44-9 pancake type GM detector, a model 44-2 gamma scintillator, and a model 133-6 high range gamma detector. The 2241-3 has a rotary switch for turning the meter on and selecting the detector setting. There is an audio switch to turn the audible clicks on and off. A switch labeled FS controls the response time of the instrument. The light button will illuminate the meter display for a short period of time. A reset button to drive the display back to zero. There is also a protected toggle switch to change from rate mode to scaler mode and vice versa. This switch has to be pulled up before it can be toggled. A couple of notes on the controls. Most first responders typically only use the rate mode and don't use the scaler mode. And by the same token, most first responders typically only use the fast time constant and don't use the slow time constant. But your local procedures should take precedent. Connect the C cable to the model 2241-3 and connect the other end to the 44-9. Turn the rotary switch to the detector 1 position. The instrument will go through a quick boot up process. Ensure the low battery symbol is not displayed. If it is, replace the batteries. Hold the 44-9 by the rubber grip. Remove the protective cap or optional dose filter from the face of the detector in order to be able to detect alpha, beta, and gamma radiation. Note that in the detector 1 setting, the meter is displaying counts per minute or CPM. A check source test should be performed once daily or before each use, whichever is less frequent. Perform the check source test by opening the check source cover door and placing the face of the 44-9 against the check source. Compare the reading to the reference reading listed on the calibration sticker on the side of the meter. If the reading is within plus or minus 20%, then it passed the test and the instrument is ready to use. If not, the detector should be taken out of service. Be sure to turn off the meter before changing detectors to avoid damaging either the detector or the 2241. In this example, we are disconnecting the 44-9 and connecting the 44-2 detector. Connect the model 44-2. We match the colored dots on the detector to the colored dot on the meter. Turn the rotary switch to the detector 2 setting. The instrument is now displaying micro R per hour readings. Hold the 44-2 like a flashlight to make a measurement. If necessary, perform a check source test as was done on the detector 1 setting. Detector number 3 is the model 133-6, and it reads in R per hour. It can be held either pointed at the suspected source of radiation, or it can be held sideways. Detector number 4 is once again the model 44-9, but is calibrated to read in MR per hour. Leave the cover on when using the 44-9 in the detector 4 setting. That is all for the quick start guide for the model 2241-3 RK2.